So we started off looking at what could we do to make a product that would be embodying our values, what we're trying to achieve.
Normally, when we have a client and they ask us to design a product, the focus is really about desirability in the product, the utility or functionality of the product, and the manufacturability. All those things are important, but Fairphone had a real focus on durability, repairability, storytelling. Those were the kind of issues that we had to incorporate into the phone.
The challenge is, if you want to make a phone that lasts longer, you're going against kind of the trend of the whole industry.
If you think that really most manufacturers try and dissuade you from getting into your phone, it's sort of a bit of an unknown landscape for people. You can go on YouTube and you can find out how to repair your phone, but you know, it looks like open heart surgery and you need a whole toolkit of sort of spudgers and tweezers and things to be able to do that.
How do we make sure that people can actually repair and keep using their phones that they already have? So we started looking into what actually happens to the phone that made them die or suffer accidents, and try to then isolate these subsystems to make sure that we can actually address the maintenance, the repairability. So that's how we got into a modular architecture.
I came to look to have a try on the new Fairphone 2. I like the idea of a phone that is fair, the idea that you can replace parts easily so you don't have to throw your phones away as soon as something doesn't work on the phone.
It was cool to actually see how all the parts came apart and how you could replace things. And
it's the right size, very light, very easy to open and to dismantle.
I really love the fact that you can repair it, because I care a lot about where my phone is coming from. I care a lot about environmental condition and condition of the workers.
Now with Fairphone 2, because we were able to design the phone ourselves, we have much more influence also in designing the supply chain behind it, and now have much more access to these suppliers.
I was looking at the whole production chain that, that they watch pretty carefully about how it's produced.
So for us it was really, really important to be able to have control over the materials, the processes in which phones are made, and also to be able to design a phone with sustainability in mind. And that's why we developed it from scratch. And that's a huge difference. We have more control over the whole ecosystem of the phone.
Now you do not need a screwdriver to change the screen of your Fairphone. And we've never seen this in any smartphone before. We were dreaming that something like this would happen, and Fairphone quietly has done it.
The screen is the thing that breaks the most. It's the most fragile piece of the phone. I will make sure that you could swap your phone display in 10 seconds, basically, right? So I can just swap out the display. If it's cracked, it's damaged, and put a new one, and off I go.
Actually, what you see outside of the phone, it is a real protective case. So people are really happy with that, that kind of the protection to the phone is built within. It's not like you buy a very beautiful phone and then you just put it in a case because you don't want to break it. Like, the case is thought with the design of the phone itself.
There's a certain pride to it as well. If you keep your phone longer, and if you can show it to people that you had your phone for a long time, you should be proud if you are able to do that. See it like a car you maintain and you keep up to date. At a certain time, it becomes an old timer and it becomes more worth than the new one, right?